think that's us live. Absolutely fabulous. Right. Good afternoon and welcome to the Eurovision Song Contest. We present Norway, Switzerland, Sweden. Oh no, it's not, is it? Sorry, my mistake. I'm going to take this out because that's just weird. Okay, so yeah, it's quiz time again. It's Friday afternoon and we have the usual victims slash contestants. But that doesn't mean we cannot introduce them in our usual manner. Starting off with Mr. Cutler, what's your name, where'd you come from?
Well, my name's Mr. Cutler and I come from lovely Shoebriness.
Lovely Shoebriness.
Lovely Shoebriness.
Not lovely Shoebriness, lovely
Shoebriness.
Is that next to Shoebriness?
Yeah, it's just a little bit further on.
Right, no, that's it. First, we've got Mr. Cutler. Mr. Spence, what's your name? Where'd you come from? Please don't say I covered in Milton Hall because I'm tired of that as a response.
My name is Mr. Spence. I do live in a cupboard in Milton Hall. Very sorry, but it's true.
Well, we're going to have to rehouse you or rehome.
I'm trying.
Just
apparently, I'm quite low on the priority.
I won't say anything because I've got bills to pay. That's lovely. So, Mr. Spence from the cupboard under the stairs, very much Harry Potter. Is that why the hair?
Is it Harry Potter-esque hair?
Is it good form to answer a question with a question?
I don't know. You tell me.
Next, Chayan, what's your name? Where'd you come from?
Chayan from Cloud City.
From Cloud City. Oh, I wish I knew what that was. Is that a good thing? Are you happy there? Do you have a large house there?
Yeah.
Fine, okay, that's perfect, well done. Lovely. Johan, what's your name, where'd you come from?
My name is Johan, and do you mean where I live? Or do you mean where I was born?
I don't know, that's a particularly difficult question. I'll be honest with you, I'm not overly interested in the answer, really, I'm just doing it for the sake of form. Where do you, let's go with, where do you live? Okay, don't give us the number. We get into all sorts of trouble with DJ and things. So yeah, good lord, it's gone. It's Kayla.
Kaylee.
Oh, that's what I was going to say. Cheyenne. It's Kaylee with an E. Kaylee, what's your name? Where'd you come from?
My name's Kaylee, and I come from
America. Good lord, that's a very long way to travel each day. Thank you for coming in today, Kaylee. So, and finally, Rosie, what's your name? Where'd you come from?
Hi, I'm Rosie, and I'm from Southend.
You're from Southend, absolutely fabulous. So we have America, Cloud Cuckoo Lands, the cupboard under the stairs. What a vast variety of different places we have. Whilst we are considering our times table round, you, the audience, all of you, all 1,000 of you, I believe, who are logged in today. You need to vote. You need to decide who is going to take part in our dancing round. So that is your opportunity to vote now. Please vote. Will it be, who would you like to see dancing? Would you like to see Mr. Spence dancing? Would you like to see Johan dancing? Would you like to see Rosie dancing? Very partisan audience over there. Would you like to see Mr. Cutler dancing? I mean, Mr. Cutler dancing is actually a thing, isn't it? Would you like to see the Cloud City resident dancing? Or would you like to see Kaylee, who's pretending to be Kayla, dancing today?
No,
who would you like to vote for today? Who are we going to vote for today? Who's going to do our dancing round? Because just to speed things along, as soon as we get our results, we will be sending those people off to the green room. When I say speeding things along, that's what we need to do. Speed things along.
Speed it along.
So, Mr. Cutler, are you able to get your results through?
I have already got results for the other team who have already come through.
Oh, fabulous. So,
Surprisingly, let me guess.
Mr. Spence.
Yes.
Mr. Spence, would you mind terribly reporting to the green room and put on your
smart... Would it matter if I said yes, I do mind terribly?
I don't know.
Probably not.
I suspect we'd have to yellow card you. You've already got all the others. This team...
I don't know about my team yet. I'm still waiting.
Oh, right. Okay, sorry, Mr. Cutler.
I think they're just voting now, by the looks of it.
Oh, look, that looks very exciting. Voting now.
Voting now. So hopefully it'll say Kaylee.
I'm hoping it says you, Mr. Cutler.
Any minute now, we're going to get our results through. many.
That one just had to write them. This is how I find out the results. Oh, unsurprisingly, it's me,
Mr. Smith.
Yeah.
Oh, you as well.
It's me.
Oh, okay.
Yes. So. Enjoy the time playing. You do well.
Okay, right. So, as Mr. Cutler and Mr. Spence buckle on their sparkly cap boots and disappear off to the green room to strut their funky stuff, we will start with the Times table round. Oh. So it's going to be one person from each team, and we will pick it in the usual manner. Rosie, what's your favourite colour?
Purple.
Johan, what's your favourite colour?
I like any colour.
Not any colour. You like any colour but yellow. Okay, so hang on a second. Right, that's a tie for that one. Johan, what's your favourite animal?
Cheetah.
Okay. 18 points. So, Rosie, what's your favourite animal?
I don't know.
You love them all.
I do like koalas.
Ah, koalas. Well, how fortunate is that? Because koala was the correct answer. So you will do the times table for your team. You will have exactly some random time. We'll do it for 30 seconds, yeah? It'll be fine, honestly. Okay. Answer as many as you can in 30 seconds. Are you ready? Okay, good. Here we go. Go. 3 times 9.
27.
Correct. 2 times 12.
2 times 24.
Correct. 11 times 3.
33.
Correct. 6 times 4.
24.
Correct. 6 times 9.
54.
Correct. 9 times 2.
18.
Correct. 7 times 11.
77.
Correct. 7 times 4.
28.
Correct. 12 times 2.
24
is correct. 11 times 10.
110.
Correct. 4 times 11.
44.
Correct. 7 times 5.
35.
And that concludes your voting. You need to clap then. Do you want to tell what your score is?
No.
Okay. Pause that. Right, well, you got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. Right. Cheyenne, what's your favourite colour?
Orange.
Kaylee, what's your favourite colour? Of course it is. What other colour would it be? Okay. Cheyenne, favourite animal?
A panda.
Very strong answers here. Kaylee, favourite animal?
Koala.
Oh, I see what she did there. Double indemnity. Fabulous. So, hang on, add up scores together. And we end up with 397. Carry 2 over the 3. Fine. So, Chain, ready? Okay, so you've got 30 seconds. Let's just reset this. On your marks. Get set. Go. 2 times 12.
24.
Correct. 11 times 3.
33.
Correct. 6 times 4.
24.
Correct. 9 times 2.
18.
Correct. 7 times 11.
77.
Correct. 7 times 4.
28.
Correct. 12 times 2.
24.
Correct. 11 times 10.
110.
Correct. 4 times 11.
44.
Correct. Sorry, I didn't quite stop there. So I'm going to have to discount your last answer. So, let's give them a round of applause. At the end of that round, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You scored 9. That is fabulous. So we've got a 9 and a 12. Do you think?
Yeah.
Oh, we had the same problem last time. Oh. Hey! Hey, I did it! That's absolutely fabulous. So, at the end of our first round, we have 1 point to year five. Not quite so many points to year three. Well done, guys. Okay, so we are going to cut over to our studio for our dancing competition. And we have the very lovely Mr. Spence and the very lovely Mr. Cutler. And they will be dancing for your dedication. I will be scoring them for their technical merit. I will be scoring them for their grace and poise. I will be scoring them for their artistic interpretation. And I will be scoring them for just general ability and how funny they are.
What type of dance is it?
What type of dance? I believe that Mr. Cutler does a tango.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and I think Mr. Spence, he does... Are you familiar with Whip Nae Nae?
Yeah.
God. So I believe that Mr. Spence just endlessly does Whip Nae Nae. Watch me whip. Oh, watch me nae nae. Oh, watch me whip. Watch me nae nae. Yeah, so I think he does that. Or maybe... Oh, and we're all set.
Oh, I'm a gummy bear. Yes, I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a yummy, tummy, funny, lucky gummy bear. I'm a jelly bear, cause I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a moving, grooving, jamming, singing gummy bear. Oh, yeah. Gummy, 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 gummy bear. Gummy, 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 gummy bear.
Pretty much four. Whilst that is going on, this is your opportunity to vote for the next round. So decide who you would like. It's the charades round, so there'll be some acting out. So whilst the dancing is carrying on, then we do have the opportunity to vote for the next round, which is, as I say, our charades. So Spence has been taken back to his trailer, and even now, even as we speak, he's being gently resuscitated after the enormous amount of effort. Ah, well, I'm looking forward to this one. No, it's not the tango, is it? No. Well, I don't know this one, so I might have ordered a little bonus point. Anybody can tell me what the song is? Or is there a song playing? Is it? I mean, because I can't hear anything. I just wonder if it's just...
Books barely down the street, the brick pool way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of speed. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip. To the sound of the beat, yeah. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust, and another one gone, and another one done. Another one bites the dust, hey, hey, I'm gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust.
So there he is, Mr. R, and there you go. Certainly, it's only work like that, Joan. I don't actually have a vote, I'm afraid. I'm just merely here to facilitate things. So there we have some fine dancing there. We're just waiting for Mr. Cutler and Mr. Spence to make their way back from the green room. I will be totting up their scores to see quite how well they're done. Let's give Mr. Spence a round of applause. Extremely well done, Mr. Spence.
Thank you very much.
Just waiting for Mr. Cutler to return. I mean, I don't want to spoil the result for you, Mr. Spence, but you did win.
Excellent.
Because anyway, But, you know, it's very much, again, like Barbie.
Oh.
We won't tell the other team if they won or not. So, there you go.
Don't tell me.
We could do, I think we should do Bargain Hunt. I feel we should have a yeah. We could do
Can't
Bargain Hunt. Oh, right. Round the second-hand shops in Westbury. You've got to calm yourself. Right, okay, so I'll judge your performance first, Mr. Spence, if I may.
You may.
I can see you're very excited about that.
I am.
You seem to be leaping, but that's fine. Your technical merit, I thought you were in time. Your moves were very, very similar to the ones that you were supposed to be doing, so that was very, very good. You put a lot of energy into it, I thought. You smiled throughout. You looked as though you were genuinely enjoying yourself, and that was lovely to see.
It's the highlight of my day.
I say there was a lot of technical ability there, and you made us laugh as well. We did enjoy your performance, so that was very good. So I'm going to give you 17.75 points for that.
Thank you very much.
Mr. Cutler.
Mr. Smith.
You see, I have to say, more or less throughout, Mr. Spence slightly more on the technical side.
Possibly agree with that.
And I have to say that the moves that the people were doing on the screen had almost a passing resemblance to some of the moves you were making. Now, I'm going to put that down to artistic interpretation.
I'm going to say
that actually, because you are such a creative and such a free spirit, that you weren't to be governed by the confines of music or
exactly.
Or dancing or good taste or any of those things. I'm going to give you a very, very, I feel it's a generous score, and I'm going to give you 17.75 points. So that round there. I'm sorry, Mr. Spence. It's just, I Mr. Cutler, whilst without your technical ability, did have that enthusiasm. Yeah, so there you go.
Well done, Mr. Cutler.
So, at the end of that, we have 2 points. By now, we should have had the voting for our next round. Whilst you're thinking about that,
I believe the voting is in.
Voting is in.
I believe so. I think Rosie and Kaylee have won the vote.
Rosie and Kaylee. Let me explain. Can you, whilst we are carrying on this next round, could you please be voting for the round after that, which is our Cups round? So please be voting for the Cups round. Let me explain this next round. It's ever so straightforward. It is called Animal Charades. And there's a little theme tune to this one.
Yes.
Animal Charades. Animal Charades. We're going to play Animal Charades.
Have you written that one yourself, Mr. Smith?
I have a team. You've met them. I call them Team 5.
Excellent.
It's a very, very loose term. There's no I in team. There is in mine. So, Kaylee. And who was the other one? Sorry.
Rosie.
Kaylee and Rosie. Rosie is quite straightforward. You'll perform a number of charades to your team. They are animals. You have 1 minute to do as many of the charades as you possibly can, and at the end of that, the person with the most charades will win.
How do we know what animal again?
Hang on. Which one would you like? That one or that one? Right, you need to place yourself in front of the team, but also place yourself in front of the camera. So about here.
About here.
So, I will start you on my 55th whistle. Hang on a second, because I need to find out what. That's fine, you're absolutely fine. It's just as long as we can see you.
Ah,
perfect. Oh, that is very good. Got the professionals in. Okay, so, Rosie, you have 1 minute to perform as many animals as humanly possible to your team starting now.
Kangaroo.
Rabbit. Yes.
Cat.
Yes. Fish.
Goldfish.
Yeah.
Snake.
Yes. How do I do this?
Lion.
No.
Tiger.
No.
Dinosaur.
Really?
T-Rex.
Yeah.
Tyrannosaurus Rex.
Yes, that's it.
Yeah!
I know I can answer that.
You're very, very well done. You stood it to me. Frighteningly good. We can allow substitutions. Well done, mister.
Just substituting for Karen.
I know, that's fine.
She wants to guess. She really wants to guess.
No, she was very, very
keen. She's like, I want to guess, Mr. Keller. I'm going to come over here because I'm kind of big and I've been most cameras, to be honest, with us, man.
Absolutely lovely. So, right. Mr. Keller, are you ready?
I am ready.
Have you composed yourself? Go.
Frog.
Yep.
Dog.
Yep.
Dog.
I have no idea how to do this.
Oh, I know. Shark.
I like your song.
There'll be a dolphin, unbelievably.
It's one of them. Yes.
Rabbit. Yes. Kaylee, you're a fantastic guesser. A round of applause for Kaylee.
Wow. I'll be honest, I'm astounded that went as well as it did. There was some fine quality acting there, wasn't there? I mean, dinosaur, Tyrannosaurus Rex. I mean, Mr. Spence, how would you that's a sentence we'll just re-examine. How would you have done a Tyrannosaurus Rex?
I think I've got the...
Mr. Spence.
Oh, that's a good thing. That's absolutely scary. Kaylee, how would you have done a dolphin, you think? Difficult one.
I just buy them from the roll.
There you go, just dive on the roll.
That's what went wrong. If I just dive on the floor, start rolling, you'd be
like, I wonder, and I'm a bit vague on these things, does a dolphin have a blowhole? Does it squirt water at its thing?
I thought
it was a shark.
I always
do that. It does, it does. So, my incorporation of a blowhole into my mind would have been a...
You may have tended to go whale on that one.
Okay. We hopefully have some votes in on our cups. Because whilst we are doing the cups... Mr. Cullen, it's like being in the theatre, they change the scenes. The set amount of animosity
is just settling.
Can I just point out, guys, whoever does the cuts won't do the VR, so the virtual reality. So whoever does the virtual reality.
We're going to see, wait for the votes.
Okay, so we shall vote for the votes. Good Lord, these aren't my teeth. Who will do the cups? Who was Miss Pink? I've had to come in every single day.
Here goes.
I'm entirely in my class winning the attendance cup. This is making me very, very entertaining.
We can vote.
So who have we got for the cups?
Right.
Who is that?
Who have we got?
Just waiting. The vote is in. And it is Johan.
Johan for the cups. Who have we got for the cups on the other team?
You've got to share. Come on.
Just waiting for the vote to come up, Mr.
Smith. So we got Johan. I'm very tense. Please don't do this to me.
It
is. I'm having medication today.
Cheyenne.
No. Yeah.
Come on, Johan. You've got it.
So, whilst Johan and Cheyenne are doing their cup stacking, we need to be voting on the VR so that we can then dispense people to the VR. So we'll be curious. Let me explain. Are you ready for this, Cheyenne? Ready? Very, very, very carefully. You need to do this twice. You start with a flat stack.
Yeah.
Then it's a four, it's a two. I'm sung the song. We're going to stack some carps. We're going to stack the carps. Stack the cups. Stack the cups. That's the cup stack. Then what you need to do, I wrote that one myself. Then what you need to do is deconstruct. Now, if you do this, then it's slightly quicker. And then you start over again. We're going to stack. You don't have to sing the song if you don't want to. You're going to stack the cups. We're going to stack the cups. Join in when you feel confident. We're going to stack the cups. We're going to stack the cups. Perfect. Now, breathe some water. Head in that direction, I feel. And remember, we then deconstruct. So, who would like to go first? Thank you, Johan.
Come on, Johan, you go this.
Well, we're going. Two of us have to go to get ready for the VR, and from that team, it is Rosie.
Johan, there's not an audition, there's not a particularly fabulous start, is it?
Go, Johan, you can do this.
You've got this, Johan.
Okay. So, let me wait until I start the timer. Ready, steady, a go.
Yeah, I'm gonna stack the cart.
Excellent idea. It saves me having to wash them each time. I'm glad you're on this, Mr. Spence. It's very, very good. I see what you've done there. Oh, these are the same sort of cups, though, aren't they?
Same sort
there's
of
no,
cups.
There's no favouritism happening here. So, right.
Show your hands up.
Remember, it's a four, a three, a two, and a one. Let's do that. I'm going to count you down from five, four, three, two, one, go.
Okay, it's gonna stack the cups. Chet's gonna stack the cups. Chet's gonna stack the cups. Chet's gonna stack the cups.
Skip those cups.
Chet's gonna stack the cups. Chet's gonna stack the cups.
Deconstruct now. Stack the cups. Deconstruct. Stack the cups. Deconstruct.
And stack the cups. Ah! Chet's gonna stack the cups
again.
Chet's gonna stack the cups. He's turning a different route this time.
I can't actually see. I've got Charon in the way.
Jazz gonna stack the cups. Jazz gonna stack the cups.
One more time.
Deconstruct
now.
Deconstruct
the cups.
We're not going to use any more.
Deconstruct the cups. No,
it's done.
Well done.
It's done.
Well,
that's
close. You took 10 seconds less. So an absolutely fabulous round. So
well done, Charon.
So I feel, as we're going into our last round, we've got a tie situation going on. I'm so pleased when that switches off. So, as we go into our final round, which is the VR round, I know Mr. Cutler has been practicing this at home. Yeah, but it's a bit odd because he hasn't got a VR one, you know. It does make it somewhat, I believe, he puts an old pair of swimming goggles on and a little picture that he's drawn, and then he just shakes his maracas about. And yeah, that's it's just, I don't know if it's the same. I don't know if it works the same. There's some interesting techniques. You missed out on those, Mr. Spence, because you had some pretend meeting you had to go to.
I did.
And you had, there was two very distinct, hello, team, pay attention, I'm being hilarious. Or I might be giving you some pointers, or some combination of the both. You had the proper full-on shake your maracas thingy, and you had the controlled campanology bell ringing. It was very good. So yeah, so there you go. So I'll be interested to see, is it maracas? Is it bell ringing? Bell ringing or maracas? What do you think, Hayley? What do you think? What do you think the individual teams would be doing in terms? Do you think Mr. Cutler's any good at this? You think he's going to do maracas? What do you think, Johan? Do you think Mr. Cutler's going to be one of these? Or is he going to be a... What do you think? Well, you see, if Mr. Cutler's going to his dancing... Oh, there he goes. Great job. That's going to be fun. No, it's not, is it?
No.
It's almost like... Don't know if Rose has ever danced before. The idea of the game is...
Oh, I haven't been...
Well, you know, never mind. Okay, hopefully we'll see you next week. If we're not taking up the air. There you go. The time up. Good lord.
Yes, Rosie.
That looked.
I think Mr. Cutler's gonna.
Very, very short. I have to say that was a very, very short round. Maybe that's because Rosie scored the maximum number of points in a very short period of time. I don't know. We shall find out in due course. So all we have to do now, they're just strapping Mr. Cutler into the headset, bandaging up his wrists, because he's a man of a certain age. I'm looking forward to what I'm sure will be a fine performance by Mr. Cutler. As I say, if you haven't got a VR machine at home, what you can do is just, if you take the lenses out of some swimming goggles and just walk around. And it's very much like VR. It's very similar to virtual reality. I often do that at Milton Hall. Just walk around with a big pair of some swimming goggles on and pretend it's reality.
I did wonder what you're doing.
Well, I mean, there are times
Mr. Cutler looks like he's really good. Wow.
I'm going to get more. Cutlass, you're worried. You go, oh, I don't know about this. And it flies by.
But now I'm not. No, I'm not.
Hello, right, we're back. I'm just waiting for a score of Mr. Cutler. Either will do, because everything hinges. Everything hinges on this last round. Will it be the year threes? Will it be the year fives? Will it be the year
threes?
There's quite an age difference here. You can take, we take an average of the age over here.
Mr. Cutler,
I don't know what the scores are.
Right, I have my birthday text, Timmy. Bungie, 325.
And I got
425.
Oh!
Yeah! Yeah, beat you! Just slightly beat you, I was pipping you in the post
there, my love. 300
in
it. Good lord. So,
it's fun up to
me. Isn't that exciting? If you've enjoyed this, and let's face it, who hasn't? Tell your friends. Remember, it goes on YouTube this afternoon. We went viral last week, Mr. Spence. We had 15 views.
Amazing.
Honestly, I didn't realise.
That's fantastic.
We're all over the internet.
Wow.
For lots of different reasons. So, at the end of that, we need to give the runners-up, because there's no losers.
Of course not.
The runners-up, Team 5. Little round of applause. But our champions of champions, our winners, our lauded, wonderful year threes. Massive round of applause. Very well done. Would you like to know what you've won?
What?
Well, it rhymes with nothing. Nothing.
Nothing.
No, unfortunately, there are no prizes. There's just the knowledge that you've just kicked the backsides of this team over here. Right, resoundingly. So that's enough. So,
my
okay. You go McDonald's. You go where you like. You do what you like. There will be no fun. There's no monetary gain in this quiz. Thank you again, ladies and gentlemen. We are here every single Friday at 1:30. Please join us. Please join in. Please vote. It is all the more fun if you vote and join in. But we've been wonderful. You've been wonderful. Thank you very much. Good afternoon. Have a lovely weekend.
Bye. Bye.